Good morning. My name is Cynthia, and I'm a volunteer at Corunum. And that's what you were seeing passing by there, the pictures of some of our volunteers. You can't hear me? Okay, try again. Good morning. Better? Okay, good. So I'm one of the volunteers that goes to Corunum. I love it. And I'm just going to have a few minutes just to tell you a little bit about Corunum. A lot of people know about it, but a lot of people don't. Corunum is a freestanding meal center located in Lawrence, Massachusetts. Lawrence is one of the poorest cities in the United States of America and the poorest in Massachusetts. And so lots and lots of people live below the poverty line or just hanging on there. It was opened in 2006 by Father Paul O'Brien. He wanted to provide meals for anyone in need, knowing that food was available from various sources, including the Boston Food Bank. They put a team together and made a plan, and there was a parking lot across from St. Patrick's Church in Lawrence, and they constructed a freestanding meal center there. A place needed to prepare and serve food for anyone who wants to come. Corunum is amazing. It has only 3 employees, and the rest of the time it's manned by volunteers. So there's a lot of people who volunteer from various and sundry places. It serves breakfast and dinner 365 days a year. And even when they had the recent gas explosions in the city of Lawrence, we served meals. We bagged breakfast, and we bagged dinner, and we handed it out at the door because the building was not deemed safe at that point. And for 3 weeks, we did that. It's open every single day. They serve approximately or greater than 200,000 meals a year, well over 2 million in the last 12 years since it's been open. This is done with no cost to the guest. Everyone is welcome. Meals are not limited to Lawrence residents. Anyone who comes is welcome. All the guests are greeted at the door and welcomed personally by a volunteer. There are flyers that were passed out as you came in the door today. We ask you to take a look at them, take them home, read them. There is a website. You'll be quite impressed. There's phone numbers and email addresses of committee members. If you have questions, we're also going to be at the back of the church and in the, I'm going to call it the coffee room after Mass. For me, Corunum is a wonderful opportunity to make a difference. Our guests are our brothers and sisters in Christ. We are called by God through our faith to care for one another. Many of our guests live in poverty. Some of them live alone, and they come because they want a little bit of fellowship. Some are homeless. Many of them in this freezing cold weather live under the bridge or in doorways. So we have quite a range of people come. Others come to spread out their budget. Sometimes we have families that come, especially when we have dinner on the weekends. Each and every person is our guest and treated with the utmost respect and welcome. Our volunteers are wonderful. The people that I volunteer with in different days for breakfast or for dinner are amazing. The teamwork is great. While doing service, you meet others who have a desire to make a difference for this population. We're really looking to see if we can't increase our volunteer base because people are busy and can't always come. So we're asking you to look into your hearts and see if maybe you can join us. There are slips at the end of the pews. If you are willing, if you could put your name in. Contact information, we'll collect it at the back of the church. We'll put you on a list. Once a month, we send out a calling and ask if for volunteers. And if you're on the list and you're not busy and you want to come, please join us. All right. Thank you.
morning.
Good
morning. My name is Rachel Rogers, and I'm the Director of Adult Faith Formation here at the Christ Initiative. Whether this is your first time with us, or you've been a member of our parish family for many years, we are so glad you came to be with us today. You are welcomed and wanted in our church. We come together not as a random collection of people, but as a family God is calling together. In that spirit, let's take a moment to turn to the folks near us and greet one another with a word of welcome. During Mass, we have the opportunity to hear God speaking to us. If you have your cell phone with you, please check at this time to make sure that it's in silent mode so as not to disturb you or others during this moment of sacred prayer. At this Mass, we remember in a particular way Claire Lyons Callahan. Just a couple very brief announcements. Tonight's youth group will be held at the Bake Shop downtown. That will be after the 6 p.m. Mass, so all high school students are welcome for that. And then finally, the marriage retreat that we're holding in Stowe, Vermont, March 1st through 3rd. Sign-ups will be closing within the next day or so, and I'm really, really hoping to get just a few more couples to sign up. So if you or anyone that you know might be interested, please reach out to me. I can be reached at the parish office or also at rrogers@theci.me. And it's going to be just an awesome experience. So hopefully just a few more couples. So please pray about that and reach out to me if you're interested. Confessions will be heard Monday evening, February 18th, from 6 to 7 p.m. here at St. Rose. I now invite you to lift your voice in our processional song here at this table.
Please stand.
Father, and the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
As we gather together today, let us pause for a moment. Let us ask God to forgive us our sins. Let us reflect upon our lives, and let us ask God to give us the grace to forgive others and to go forward the way God loves us. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned. In my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and in what I have failed to do, through my fault, through my fault, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask the Blessed Mary, ever virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Keep your family safe, O Lord, with unfailing care, that relying solely on the hope of heavenly grace, they may be defended always by your protection through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. Amen.
And at this point, I almost forgot, I think we have Pathfinders today, don't we? So, Pathfinders, come on up, come on up. I don't know what you're going to do, but you're going to have a good time doing it, so. I'm not kidding. One day I am just going to go in there, and you're going to be on your own.
First reading is a reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. In the year King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord seated on a high and lofty throne, with the train of his garment filling the temple. Seraphim were stationed above. They cried to one another, "Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. All the earth is filled with his glory." At the sound of that cry, the frame of the door shook, and the house was filled with smoke. Then I said, "Woe is me, I am doomed, for I am a man of unclean lips, living among a people of unclean lips. Yet my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts." Then one of the seraphim flew to me, holding an ember that he had taken with tongs from the altar. He touched my mouth with it and said, "See, now that this has touched your lips, your wickedness is removed, your sin purged." Then I heard the voice of the Lord saying, "Whom shall I send? Who will go for us?" "Here I am," I said, "send me." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you. sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. I will sing
in the sight.
Give thanks to you, O Lord, with all my heart, for you have heard the words of my mouth. In the presence of the angels, I will sing your praise. I will worship at your holy temple. Kindness and your truth, for you have made great above all things your name and your promise. When I called, you answered me. You built up strength within me.
In the sight of
kings of the earth shall give thanks to you, O Lord, when they hear the words of your mouth, and they shall sing of the ways of the Lord. Great is the glory of the Lord.
In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. I will sing. I will sing.
Your right hand saves me. The Lord will complete what he has done for me. Your kindness, O Lord, endures forever. Forsake not the work of your hands.
In the sight of the angels, I will sing your praises, Lord. I will sing.
Second reading is a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. I am reminding you, brothers and sisters, of the gospel I preached to you, which you indeed received and in which you also stand. Through it you are also being saved, if you hold fast to the word I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I handed on to you as of first importance what I also received, that Christ died for our sins in accordance with the scriptures, that he was buried, that he was raised on the third day in accordance with the scriptures, that he appeared to Cephas, then to the 12. After that, he appeared to more than 500 brothers at once, most of whom are still living, though some have fallen asleep. That after that, he appeared to James, then to all of the apostles. Last of all, as to one born abnormally, he appeared to me. For I am the least of the apostles, not fit to be called an apostle, because I persecuted the church of God. But by the grace of God, I am what I am, and his grace to me has not been ineffective. Indeed, I have toiled harder than all of them, not I, however, but for the grace of God that is with me. Therefore, whether it be I or they, so we preach, and so you believe. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Brothers and sisters, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Luke.
Glory to you, Lord.
While the crowd was pressing in on Jesus and listening to the word of God, he was standing by the lake of Genesaret. He saw two boats there alongside the lake. The fishermen had disembarked and were washing their nets. Getting into one of the boats, the one belonging to Simon, he asked him to put out a short distance from the shore. Then he sat down and taught the crowds from the boat. After he had finished speaking, he said to Simon, "Put out into deep water and lower your nets for a catch." Simon said in reply, "Master, we have worked hard all night and have caught nothing. But at your command, I will lower the nets." When they had done this, they caught a great number of fish, and their nets were tearing. They signaled to their partners in the other boat to come and help them. They came and filled both boats so that the boats were in danger of sinking. When Simon Peter saw this, he fell at the knees of Jesus and said, "Oh, depart from me, Lord, for I am a sinful man." For astonishment at the catch of fish they had made seized him, and all those with him. And likewise James and John and the sons of Zebedee, who were partners of Simon. And Jesus said to Simon, "Do not be afraid. From now on you will be catching men." When they brought their boats to shore, they left everything and followed him. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Who here has ever failed at something? Oh, liars, liars, liars. You're in church. I saw. I expect to see everybody's hand up for that. Okay, we've all, whether we admit it or not, failed at things in life. Every single one of us. Minor, major, probably a few doozies along the way, right? Absolutely. We've all failed. We've all felt inadequate at some point in time. We've all felt maybe unworthy of X, Y, or Z. There's a thing in academia where you're just waiting for someone to figure out that you're a complete and total fraud at what you do. It's this PhD weird neurosis thing. But everybody fails at something. Everybody feels less than at some point in time. And the words that came to me when I was thinking about this gospel, these readings, were failure, unworthy, called, loved. In the first reading, we heard about Someone who was called to be a prophet and didn't feel worthy of that call, and yet God calls him anyway. In the gospel, we hear, "I am a sinful man, go away from me." And Jesus' response is basically, "Get over it. I'm choosing you." And it's easy, I think, on some levels to think about a call in very distinct categorical terms and forget that every single one of us, every single one of us, has been called by Christ. It's not just me. It's not just the music ministers. It's not just Father Michael. It's not just the Pope. It's not just Sister Jean. It's you. You have been called by Christ. Have I failed in my life? You better believe it. Have I done stupid things? Yes. Have I done great things badly? Yes. Have I sinned? Big time. None of your business, but big time. Have I ever felt, "What are you doing?" Yeah. And yet, as I've been reminded as of late, for whatever reason, God decided to call me to do what I'm doing. So despite the fact that the world teaches us to feel unworthy about XYZ, despite the fact that we fail, despite the fact that, guess what, we're human, you've got a call. I don't know what yours is. You might not know either. But you have one. She's like, "Why did I sit in the front row?" Maybe that's why. But we need to learn to listen. We need to realize that God can heal us of whatever we need to be healed of so that we can answer that call. We need to realize that God gives us the strength to say, "Here I am. Send me." So encourage each other. Hold each other up. Recognize the gifts that you have and celebrate them. Recognize the gifts that those around you have and celebrate them. Because they are needed. They are wanted. And God has deemed you worthy to share them. So share them. Failure, unworthy, called, loved. Anybody here a scientist by any chance? Okay. Then you know, and correct me if I'm wrong here, that failure is important. We have to learn from the mistakes in order to really get down to the essence of what's true, what works, what's best. So take your failures as successes, because now you know something you didn't before. Take your sense of unworthiness and shove it out the door, because that's not God talking. Think instead of "not yet complete," or dare I say, even "good." And take all of that and use it in whatever it is you're called, so that you can help bring about more fully the kingdom of God, so that you can bring about more fully the realization of God's love, God's care, God's mercy, God's compassion, God's intense passion for us and this planet and this universe, so that somebody else might recognize that they too, no matter what anybody else says, is worthy of God's call, is worthy of God's love, for no other reason than God has determined that they too are worthy. So failure, ye unworthy, called, loved. And as you remember from another reading, the greatest of these is loved. Together, let us stand and profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And together let us place our prayers before the altar of our God.
For God's holy church, that we may heed the call of discipleship by following the Lord and bringing God's word and mercy to those in need, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the healing of divisions around the world, especially in areas where religious differences have fostered hostility and conflict, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For modern-day prophets and apostles, that their boldness in proclaiming the gospel may inspire us to put our faith into action. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For married couples, that they may be blessed in their commitment to each other and be assigned to the world of God's love for humanity. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all those who suffer from the extremes of weather, especially those without homes or basic resources, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
May we pray for Claire Lyons Callahan, whom we remember in a particular way during this Mass. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. We pray also for Kathy Marshall, who we've been asked to pray for this morning. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Loving and merciful God, we thank you for hearing our prayers spoken and unspoken. We ask you to continue to lead us and guide us by the light of your love in all we say and do. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Lord, make me an instrument of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me sow love. Where there is injury, pardon. Where there is doubt, faith. Where there is despair, hope. Where there is darkness, light. Where there is sadness, joy. O divine Master, grant that I may not so much seek to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love. For it is in giving that we receive, it is in pardoning that we are pardoned, and it is in dying that we are born to eternal life. Amen. Please be seated.
Please join in our presentation song, Come to the Water.
them come to the water.
Pray, friends, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
O Lord our God, who once established these created things to sustain us in our frailty, grant, we pray, that they may become for us now the sacrament of eternal life, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just. Our duty and our salvation always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For by his birth he brought renewal to humanity's fallen state, and by his suffering canceled out our sins. By his rising from the dead, he has opened the way to eternal life. By ascending to you, O Father, he has unlocked the gates of heaven. And so with the company of angels and saints, we sing the hymn of your praise, as without end we acclaim. Created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." And In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. For, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Saint Joseph, her husband, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Rose, Saint Agnes, Saint Augustine, and with all the saints. On his constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth with your servant Francis, our Pope, Sean, our Bishop, the Order of Bishops, the clergy, religious, and all, the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory. Through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. United in mind and heart, we pray, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may always be free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Peace, everybody. Peace.
Lamb of God,
My brothers and sisters, behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter my room, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
Finest bread I will provide.
Body of Christ.
Till
Let us pray. O God, who have willed that we be partakers in the one bread and the one chalice, grant us, we pray, so to live that made one in Christ, we may joyfully bear fruit for the salvation of the world. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Okay, who's got birthdays? Everybody's got a birthday, but who's got a birthday coming up this week? Oh, you do. How old, man? 18. Welcome to manhood. And back over here. Who's got a birthday back there? When? When's the birthday?
Friday.
Any other birthdays? Birthdays, birthdays. Anniversaries. Anniversaries. Oh, we got an anniversary over here. How many years?
49.
49. You're entering your 50th year. Well done. All right, any other anniversaries? Okay, visitors. Oh, anniversary? Anniversary? And you didn't kill him. Well done. Any other anniversaries? I'm sure he's a wonderful man. Okay, any visitors? No visitors this week. Bring a friend next week. Bring a friend. All right. There is coffee. Please tell me there's coffee. Is there coffee? Was there coffee brewing in there? There is coffee. Thank God. Coffee and donuts in the next room. Father has not had coffee yet. Can I also, I'm going to start doing this until Father Michael tells me not to. Can I see what you made today? Can I take a look at it? Can I show everybody? Is that all right? So what did you make today? So you made Jesus' footsteps. Look at that, everybody. That's really kind of cool. So you cut out Jesus' footsteps. What else? So what does it say? This is patient, understanding, unselfish. That's good. Well done. Beautiful art. Well done, kids. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Let us go in peace.
Thanks be to God.
And please join us in our closing song, Go Make a Difference.